In order to understand the devastating impact that influenza disease can have, let me take you back to the Spanish flu of 1918. This worldwide outbreak claimed more human lives in just 1 year than the duration of World War I. Since then, most of you will have heard about bird flu and swine flu. These global outbreaks highlight how it's possible for the influenza virus to be spread between humans and animals. It is difficult to predict how and when the next worldwide outbreak of flu will occur. Thankfully, there are vaccines available to help protect against influenza viruses. The fundamental principle of a vaccine is to prepare our immune systems for an encounter with a virus. The vaccine triggers our immune system to produce antibodies, and these antibodies work together like an army to fight off the infection. And these antibodies are clever because they retain a memory of the virus, such that if a vaccinated individual were to be infected by the same virus in the future, they would be better prepared to fight off the infection. But we have a problem. The influenza virus has the ability to rapidly change, and this means over time the antibodies no longer recognize the virus, and therefore the vaccines no longer protect us. So our challenge is to continuously update vaccines in order to provide the best protection for both humans and animals. Now, working with influenza viruses requires specialist containment facilities, and as you might imagine, these facilities have a very high price tag. So during my PhD, I have been generating viruses that impersonate the influenza virus. These viruses look like influenza on the outside, but they are missing key pieces of genetic material, which means they can no longer replicate inside us. Because they cannot replicate inside humans or animals, it means we no longer need the specialist facilities, and therefore we are reducing both the health risk and the cost associated for scientists. So using these safer viruses as a tool, I have been studying specific changes and how the effectiveness of vaccines changes over time. Specifically, at the moment, I'm looking at vaccines for horses. Outbreaks of influenza mean that race meetings have to be cancelled, and it's also a problem for farmers in developing countries. So far, I have found that it is possible to introduce changes into our safer viruses, and that specific changes do indeed reduce the effectiveness of vaccines over time. So the take-home messages are that we can never underestimate the influenza virus, and that we can use our safer influenza impersonator viruses to look at specific changes and measure the effectiveness of vaccines over time.